Hey guys, in today's video, we are breaking down the word tetracycline to see what clues exist in this word to help us remember it so that you don't have to spend hours memorizing other mnemonics and shortcuts just to kind of come up with the clues as to what tetracyclines do. I will share with you, there are a ton of clues in this word. I worked hard for this one, so give me some love, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification button, and we're gonna get into it right after this. So my name's Tammy, for those of you who don't know me, and I'm here at NurseMinder, and I've been giving these educational videos for several years now to help you improve your practice and knowledge around the things that you need to do as a nurse. Now, what you might notice here right away is the fact that cyclines is the ending that you will also see in the generic drug names. So remember, classification, drug names. And in this one, tetracycline is both a classification and a drug name. That's a fun fact. I have another fun fact coming up for you too. But here we have some examples: dimethylcycline, doxycycline, minocycline, and tetracycline. You see the commonality here is that cycline. So when you see this ending in a generic drug name, you can automatically associate it with tetracyclines, the classification. We learn our classifications because that gives us the structure for most of how the drugs work in that category. So now that we've identified what tetracyclines are, let's talk about what they do. So tetracyclines are a broad spectrum, meaning they take care of both gram-negative and gram-positive. So think of a shopping cart. We've got the word cart here, C-A-R-T. Well, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to draw one. So inside the cart, we have all sorts of things, so positive and negative. So now that we know it's gram-negative, gram-positive, I want to give you ideas as to exactly some diagnoses that you might see your patient have while being on a tetracycline. So we're actually going to go back two more letters, and we're going to call this size cart. So everything you need is inside this word. You don't have to go memorize any other more mnemonics, and I've seen a lot of them, but they don't make sense to me. So I'm hoping this helps you more so. So size cart, each one of these letters stands for a diagnosis that your patient may have while being on tetracyclines. Actually, I'm going to write it this way. Okay, so size cart. We have chlamydia. Y is for Lyme disease. S is for staph aureus infections. There's another C, so this is cholera. A is for acne. R is rickettsia. And T is for types of pneumonia or atypical pneumonia. So you can see by just looking at the letters that the word gives you, you can actually recall a lot of information. So we've already covered the type, the classification, the generic drugs that would match it, easy to pick out. We understand that it's gram-negative, gram-positive because everything goes in the cart, and size cart in particular is the way to remember a lot of the diagnoses that you're going to see. Now, this is not exhaustive, and it can still branch out. There are still more things it can cover, hence the shopping cart. Taking it off the shelf, putting it in. So what's so important about this is you need to do a culture and sensitivity to make sure that the bacteria, not virus, bacteria is going to be sensitive, which means that the antibiotic that we give it will actually have an impact to kill the bacteria. That's what sensitive means. All right, so I've grabbed another color here, and what we're gonna do now is look at the word tetra. Now, the word tetra itself gives us a lot of information, more than I actually thought it was going to do. So tetra we know means four. Let me just put this down. Tetra means four. Grab another pen. Okay, so tetra means four. And this is another fun fact. Tetra is based off of a common soil mold and it has four rings. Fun, interesting, right? But if we stack it like the game Tetris, you know, the stacking of the blocks, four and four is eight. Eight is the age limit. You would not want to give it to children under eight, because it affects bones and teeth. Bones are the building structure of our body. So if you remember Tetris and think of how it stacks, these are the bones. of the body, and tetracyclines are contraindicated in pregnancy because it will impact fetal development. We don't want to give it to children under 8 because they're still growing. Okay, so 4 and 8. 4 is the number of rings it has. 8 is the age limit. We don't want to give it to children under 8. Let's stack another 4. And 12 becomes the half-life. 12 to 25. So that's an interesting number too. All right. So tetra gives us a ton of information as well. So when you just look at this word, tetracycline, step back and look at this word for a moment. You can visualize Tetris, all those cubes stacking up, bones growing. The other thing is the teeth. So bones and teeth, okay? 4 rings under age of 8, we don't give it to, and 12 hours half-life. Now, size cart. We know it's everything, gram negative, gram positive, and if we use the letters size cart, then we understand the diagnoses we most likely will see in our patient. So we've got chlamydia, Lyme disease, staph aureus infections, cholera, acne, oops, I spelled Rickettsia wrong, and types of pneumonia. So when you have a patient who has these diagnoses on a tetracycline, you're like, okay, makes sense. Now I want to come back to the word cycle because there's still more in this word to be had. When I think of cycle, I think of exercise. Okay, I was never paid for my drawing. Exercise. When I think of cycling, I think of exercise. And for me, when I exercise, I don't like to eat when I exercise. It makes me feel heavy. So we do not want to give tetracyclines with food, right? So you're gonna take your medications an hour before or 2 hours afterwards. All right, so let's kind of break it down now, old school style. Now, before we go further, I've taken everything off the board with the exception of the drug names. But I want you to drop in the comments below, when you look at this word now, what do you see? Put it all in there. Let me know what's settling in for you, what was fun, what was interesting. But when you see the word tetracyclines, I want you to visualize everything that this word tells us and how it will influence your ability to care for your patients and even self-administer these medications at home. Okay? All right, so let's move forward now with the more nursing type of presentation here. So tetracyclines, what do they do? What is their site of action? Is they inhibit protein synthesis. So that results in cell death. So inhibit synthesis, if you're looking for some more clues in the word. We know it's used to treat bacterial infections and a whole variety. So just remember size, cart, plus, plus. So we're gonna put everything in the cart, negatives, positive, make sure you do a culture and sensitivity to make sure it is going to be the right drug for the right bacteria. The way it moves through the body is it's absorbed through the GI tract, the liver metabolizes it, and it's excreted by the urine. Pretty standard there. It does come in a variety of tools. So again, remember, think of size cart. It's given orally, ophthalmically, IV. So we have a variety of ways in which this drug can be given. Contraindications we talked about. Not for children under 8, not for pregnancy, not for lactating. Now, tetracyclines can be used for people who have a penicillin allergy but need treatment to cover off a bacterial infection. So if you have a penicillin allergy and you're on tetracycline, that's okay. Now let's talk next about side effects. All right, so our traditional side effects with antibiotics is always stomach upset, so nausea, vomiting, diarrhea. Want to be watching for that. Now, because tetracyclines will kill off both the normal and the bacterial flora, we can end up having super infections, so you want to watch out for things maybe that start to show up that weren't there before, like a yeast infection. Now, there's a few major adverse effects that you'd want to know with tetracyclines, and they involve bones, teeth, and skin. So we talked about bones before as the Tetris cubes were stacking, and we know that tetracyclines have an affinity for bones and teeth. That's where they like to stay. They hang out there, and then they cause some weakening in the teeth. They can cause pitting and staining and discoloration. And in the skin, it can cause photosensitivity. So we want to make sure our patients are aware of these pieces so they know to take the drugs as prescribed. And of course, what to watch for. So you want to be protecting the skin with some sunscreen, and staying out of the hottest hours, those kind of things. So this is all part of the patient education when they're on a tetracycline. So I think it's time for an NCLEx question to see how much you can remember just by looking at this word.
So we have a new prescription for minocycline 200 milligrams orally every 12 hours for our 27-year-old female patient to treat her severe acne. From the following, what would be a priority nursing action? A, tell the patient to drink lots of water to avoid the side effects of constipation. B, educate the patient on the need for contraception to prevent pregnancy. C, advise that she may have stiff joints in the morning, so to get up slowly. And D, take her blood pressure before and after taking the medication. Go ahead and pause this video and come back when you're ready. If you selected educate the patient on the need for contraception to prevent pregnancy, you got it right! Now let's look at the reason why the others are incorrect. A, tell a patient to drink lots of water. Yes, we want them to drink water, but it's not to avoid the side effect of constipation. In fact, the side effect is diarrhea, and we want them to drink regardless. C, stiff joints. We didn't talk anything about tetracycline affecting the joints. And D, blood pressure before and after the medication. Nurses, we want to do this all the time, but it's not required for this drug.
Thanks for watching, guys. This has been a fun one for me to put together, and I hope you've enjoyed this. Subscribe, make sure you hit that button for the notification when the next video comes out. I do produce content weekly, and I can't wait to see you in the next one.